Let's measure the occupied bandwidth, total channel power, and crest factor of a 20 MHz wide LTE signal. For this measurement, let's start with a clean LTE signal from the SMW200A vector signal generator at minus 10 dBm RMS, plus 1.45 dBm peak envelope power, and a crest factor of 11.45 dB, and verify those values on a spectrum analyzer. Start by presetting your spectrum analyzer. Set the center frequency to 1900 MHz. Reduce the span to 40 MHz. We'll change the trace type from auto peak to RMS. We need to do this for most modulated signals so that we can accurately measure the power. We'll increase the sweep time to 500 milliseconds. We do that in order to get a clean trace. We can see the shape of that resolution bandwidth filter. We would ideally like a little bit steeper skirts on the channel here so we can reduce our resolution bandwidth. So now let's go ahead and make an occupied bandwidth measurement. We can use the occupied bandwidth measurement function by hitting the measurement hard key, selecting occupied bandwidth. And here we see we have a little bit less than the nominal 18 MHz, about 17.8 MHz of occupied bandwidth. So let's measure the total channel power. Starting out, we'll use a band power marker function. So for that, we're going to change this measurement mode from occupied bandwidth back to a regular frequency sweep. We're going to add a marker function, band power, and we'll change the span of that to 20 MHz. We can set the frequency of that marker to 1900 MHz. And here we see in the function result about minus 10 dBm, what we expect from the signal generator, plus any cable losses. There's another way we could make this total channel power measurement, and that's to use a ACLR measurement. So for that, we're going to go to the measurement hard key, open up the channel power ACLR measurement application, and we can configure the channel accordingly. So we're going to go to a 18 MHz bandwidth and a spacing of 20 MHz from channel center to channel center. We have one transmit channel, and let's go ahead and take a look at two adjacent channels on either side of that transmit channel. So here we now have, again, about minus 10 dBm of channel power. And then we're measuring the adjacent power at 48 dB and 61 dB down for the adjacent and the second adjacent channels. In fact, if we're doing an ACLR measurement on a standard signal, we don't actually need to configure the bandwidth and spacing on our own. We have those built in as presets. So we can go to CP ACLR Config, Manage User Standards, and we can navigate to LTE downlink 20 meg. Go ahead and load that predefined XML file, which is shipped with the instrument. And now we have a 20 MHz channel. All right, let's measure the crest factor. So for that, we can use a complementary cumulative distribution function. So we'll go to measurement mode, change this to CCDF, and we'll increase that analysis bandwidth to at least cover the signal bandwidth. And for this, we have about minus 10 dBm RMS. The peak power is around 0 or 1 dBm with a corresponding crest factor. We can increase the averaging to make these values a little bit more stable. So let's increase that measurement time to 1 million samples. And there we go. About minus 10 dBm, about 1.5 dBm peak power, and about 11.4 dB crest factor. Finally, if we wanted to confirm all this within the LTE demodulation application, we can open up the LTE demodulation application using mode hard key and opening up LTE. We'll change the signal description to 20 MHz. And then we'll take a look at the power here. And we can see we have minus 10 dBm of power. And likewise, about 11, 11.5 dB Crest Factor. And if we're demodulating an LTE signal in the LTE application, we also have a shortcut to be able to measure the ACLR. Here from the measure key, open up ACLR. Thanks for watching.